I'm back after 3 weeks break, and today, as you can see, I have created this corporate look named the blushy tone. I have gave this name purposely because this suits all the fair skin tones, medium skin tones and dusky skin tones. Moreover, this is based on purely cool undertones and pink. So if you like this look and if you want to know how to create it, just keep watching. So guys, just let's get into the main video. So as you can see, I have already prepped my skin using a moisturizer. Today the video is going to be different because I will set a timer. I wanted to do this because I needed to prove that we hardly get time to do our makeup before going to office, but still you can achieve this makeup within 15 minutes. Therefore, to prove that, I'm doing this with a timer as well, and I'm not like speeding up my video. So if you want to speed up the video, you can press on the settings button and keep the speed 2x to complete the video in the shortest span of time. So I'm getting started with my makeup. As you know guys, I always start with my brows. Here I'm using the L'Oreal Brow Pomade. The shade is dark brown. Intentionally I'm not choosing black because I think it looks more dramatic. Take shorter strokes and keep doing your brows. Don't hurry while doing this step because this is very important. If you have hooded eyes, then do an arch. It will enhance your eyes. You can also use a brow powder or eyeshadow to do your brows, but make sure you keep it to the minimal. Don't make your brows look over dramatic. That doesn't suit a corporate look. You should avoid doing loud makeup. So normally my videos are not lengthy, but today for the sake of this timer, I have not edited any portion of the video. Just I tried to keep the original time so that you can see that it can actually be achieved. So I've done doing my brows right now. Then I'm using this foundation from Bobbi Brown. My shade is Warm Honey. So after taking 2 pumps, I'm just spreading it on my cheeks and I will blend it with this foundation brush. So in this video you will be able to see I will use this single brush to do each and everything. This is quite feasible because hardly we get the time to choose any brushes, which brush suits which needs. So make this as simple as possible. Keep a foundation brush handy and it will suit all your needs. Trust me. And this is the Fit Me foundation, guys. After giving one layer of Bobbi Brown, I always choose the Fit Me foundation. So yes, that was also Bobbi Brown. So this is the Fit Me foundation. My shade is 228, soft tan. I'm doing this intentionally because I love the shade of Fit Me that actually goes with my skin and enhance my skin color. But I used Bobbi Brown at first because the texture is so smooth. It keeps my skin hydrated and moreover the makeup lasts long. This is actually a result of experimentation. So I'm doing this for like 1 month now. If I purchase more variant products, I will try on them too. So for now, I'm doing this step. If you want, you can use a single foundation too, whichever suits your skin. So blend the foundation properly. Make sure you apply it on your forehead and neck, because most of the people forget to apply foundation properly on the neck and forehead and it looks horrible because it doesn't blend with your face. So everyone gets to know you have done a shitty makeup. So after doing the foundation portion, I'm going with the Fit Me concealer. My shade is 40 caramel. I'm applying it under the eyes. Apply softly with the applicator. If you want, you can also shape your brows using this. Since I have a timer going on, I did in a hurry. Now blend it with a side flat brush. The single brush I was using has two sides. One is the foundation part and one side has a flat brush. So I'm using the flat side to blend the And now I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder. My shade is medium. I'm dabbing some powder on my eyelids. You must do this step and you must also apply the powder under your eyes because you need to set the concealer. Or else after a period of time you will see the concealer has moved from its place and your I would advise you to apply the loose powder of the sponge that has a like a flat end. Since I couldn't find my sponge right now, I'm doing this with a foundation brush. So you can see I have done my whole base makeup. Now I'm going to do my conceal and blush part. If you guys are watching my video for the last 1 or 2 months, you know that I do the contouring and blushing with the same brush. And simultaneously, I don't use like first the contour or the blush part. I just mix them up because it suits my warm tone skin tone. I don't want to make a hardcore or harsh division between my blush and contouring lines. So I mix them up. And currently I'm using the Tri Sugar palette for the darker shade. So you can see how nice it looks. You hardly get to know what's between the concealer and blush. This is because if you use only the blush, your cheeks appears fully red or pink. And if you apply the contour part, your skin tone like goes down. Therefore, I mix it up. It's up to your preference. If you want, you can do it differently. And next, I am contouring my nose, which is an essential part of my makeup regime. I feel so incomplete without doing this. I'm absolutely in love with this highlighter right now and I hope to purchase the remaining two shades for suiting my other makeup looks. Now I'm applying some highlighter under my brows using a small brush, thin brush. For the sake of eyeshadow, I'm using the Makeup Revolution Warm Neutrals palette. You can skip this step guys if you don't want to apply an eyeshadow. Basically, I'm not applying a very kind of dramatic eyeshadow. I'm just applying a transition color. You can see this makes your makeup look so natural. My makeup is so simple, kind of nude makeup with a little bit of funky because the lip color would be a glossy one. But still, I feel that if you apply this eyeshadow, this will be a perfect eye makeup for you. So normally I apply some highlighter in the inner corners of my eye because I have extremely small eyes and I want my eyes to pop up. So please don't apply this highlighter with your hands in the inner corners of your eye. Make sure you use it with a brush or else there is a huge fallout. Now I am applying this eyeliner after 10 years. This is the first eyeliner launched by Lakme. I find this brush so perfect. Moreover, it is water resistant. So I would recommend you to buy this. This is so cost effective. I used it when I was in class 4 or 5 last time during my dance functions. And again, I'm using it when I'm doing a job right now. And I'm absolutely in love with this. So please purchase this, guys. If you don't know how to make wing liner, this is the perfect solution for you. You can easily do it with this brush. Moreover, the intensity of the black in this liner is like superb. The only, I would say, the flaw of this eyeliner is it doesn't dry up fast. So after you apply the liner, just keep your eyes closed for 30 seconds or 45 seconds, or else it will mix up with your eyelid. Since I'm using it after like a decade or so, I face this problem. Even in this video, I'm going to show how you correct it. So here I'm done. Quite done with my wing liner. I wish I could edit this because it's really getting lengthy, but for the sake of timer, I'm just keeping everything the way it is. And here I'm done with my eye makeup. So next, what I'm going to do is do my lips. So yes, I did my lip liner first, and again I'm going to use the same brand, another brand after 10 years. This is the Oriflame lipstick. I purchased this recently. The shade is Cranberry Blush. For further updates, follow my Instagram channel where I... So this is normally the second portion of the video. Normally I can shoot video at a stretch of 12 minutes. I was only left applying the mascara. So here I am using the L'Oreal Paris False Lash Superstar on both the lashes. So have patience while you are applying this, because you can do various mistakes like this. I was in a hurry, so the mascara got on my lid. So I will also show you how you can remove it. Now if you can avoid it, it's superb. But by chance, if you do the same mistake as I did, then you need to do certain things. Please, the first step is please don't use a makeup remover. After doing each and everything, don't use a makeup remover on a single part, because the coloration goes from that part, making the face look absolutely fake. So you can apply these various steps I'm showing you. First is, you can use the concealer if it's under your eyes or on the sides of your eyes, like while making the wing liner. So normally I was not able to find the concealer again. Okay, I found it. So I'm using the same Fit Me concealer under my eyes, where the smudging happened. And if it happened on your eyelids, then use the same eyeshadow, just a second layer of it. And now blend both of it with your fingertips. You can use a brush, you can use your fingertips, whichever suits your need. So you can see I'm quite done with the makeup. And sorry if I forgot to mention, I just applied a layer of gloss. That is, I use the Lineage Lip Slipping Mask on my lips. And here it is. I completed the entire makeup within 12 minutes 48 seconds. It can take about 15 minutes, okay? So I just combed my hair because my hair is by weight. And then you're good to go. So guys, I hope you like this video. If you like this look, then press the thumbs up and bell icon for getting further notifications. I will be back with two more new looks on corporate makeup. I will also show you accessories that you can wear to your office, not making it too loud. If you have any more suggestions, feel free to comment down below. Till then, take care and bye-bye guys. Follow my Instagram handle for further information.